To the Lebanon Rock Church online worship and message. Pastor Matt Skiles, I want to welcome you to our online worship this morning as we gather together to lift up the name of the Lord Jesus and hear the message from God's Word. I trust that the worship music that we played at the beginning of our service this morning blessed your heart. I trust you were able to enter into worship and feel the presence of the Lord. Now we're going to hear from God's Word as we share the message for you this morning. So we're going to go to the Lord in prayer and ask God to bless the message and just bless the remainder of the service. So I encourage you to take your own personal needs and requests to the Lord. You lift up your burdens and cares to the Lord. Remember, the Lord Jesus said, your heavenly Father knows you have need of all these things. So God knows what we need and knows what we are facing. Also, we want to continue to pray for the situation in Europe, especially with Ukraine, that is under attack by the Russians. And we just pray for God to bring peace to that region in the Baltics. So we're going to pray together for God's blessing and also for the needs we have in our own lives as we gather this morning. So join with me as we go to the Lord in prayer. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for the opportunity that we have to once again come together on this Sunday morning and not only enter into worship, but Lord, hear the message from the Word of God. Father, we pray that you will give your Word and this message free course in our hearts and our lives. And Father, we pray, Lord, that you will just anoint the message and the messenger. Father, we lift up our own personal individual request to you as well. Lord, we ask for you to bring healing, God, to those that are in need physically. We pray for healing, God, and strength and encouragement and restoration of health. We pray for the financial burdens and financial needs that people have. We pray you'll bless those that are seeking employment. We pray, Father, Lord, that you'll be with those that have family issues, that have situations in their marriage or with their children or their grandchildren. Father, we pray, Lord, for revival and spiritual renewal to those that need it. And Father, we especially pray, Lord, for our nation and for our world. Father, we pray for the United States of America. Lord, there's so much uncertainty, Lord, and so much uneasiness, God, that's taking place in our nation. And Father, it's because of what we're seeing happen around the world with the Ukrainian and the Russian conflict. We pray for peace, God, there in the Ukraine. We pray, God, for cooler and wiser heads to prevail and for you to restore peace, God, and restore peace to that region. And Father, we just pray, Lord, that you'll take that situation and minister now. We pray for the refugees and those that are fleeing for their safety. Protect the Ukrainian people, God, and move in that situation. Father, bless the remainder of this service now. Bless all those that have gathered to be a part of this online worship. And we give you thanks and praise in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, if you have your Bibles this morning, your tablets, your smartphones, whatever your Bible app is that you're using today, go with me, if you would, to the book of Romans chapter 8. Romans chapter 8, and we are going to begin reading at verse number 5, going all the way down to verse number 11. And this morning's message is entitled, Reset Your Mindset. Reset Your Mindset. And so we're going to talk about how we need to change the way we think. I've seen a lot of things happening over the last several days and actually several weeks with what's happening in our world and what's happening around us. And a lot of people are beginning to think negatively. A lot of people are beginning to think very, very depressing and discouraging thoughts. And that's not what God wants us to do. We serve an awesome God and we serve a mighty God. And we need to start thinking that way. And so I just want to share for a few moments this morning upon that thought of reset your mindset. So Romans chapter 8, verses 5 through 11 is where we'll take the keynote and foundational scripture that we're going to build on this morning. And we've got points we'll share and convey as we unpack the message. And I'm sure it's going to bless your heart this morning. So Romans chapter 8, let's begin reading at verse 5. I'm coming out of the New King James Bible and the King James Bible this morning, but whatever translation Bible you're using is going to be more than helpful this morning. So let's begin reading Romans chapter 8, starting with verse 5. For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God. But ye are not in the flesh, but in the Spirit, if so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin. But the Spirit is life because of righteousness. But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelleth in you. And again, we're going to share the message titled, Reset Your Mindset. Now, I share with you this morning that God wants to change the way we think and the way we live. And our primary focus in this message today is on the mind. And since that is where our emotions and our actions and the day-to-day life that we live originates, let's focus this morning on our mindset and ask God to help us to see where we need to change our thought processes and our mindset. Sometimes we have to reset our computers. Sometimes we have to restart our phone and reset the settings on our smartphone or our iPhone or our Android phone. Many times with a lot of our electronic devices, there has to be a reset that takes place. Many corporations, many businesses, organizations that have had difficult times or that have come through difficult situations, maybe division, financial loss, go through a reset or a restructuring. So the word reset is very well known in our culture. And this morning, I want to talk about how we as Christians need to reset our mindset. I found this wonderful illustration from author Craig Groeschel, who wrote a book titled The Christian Atheist. Yes, that's the title, The Christian Atheist. He defines a Christian atheist as someone who believes in God, but lives as if he or she, as if he doesn't exist. And in the preface of his book, he writes, as much as I don't want to admit it, I see this kind of atheism in myself. People might assume that a pastor wouldn't struggle with any form of atheism, but I certainly do. Sadly, he writes, Christian atheism is everywhere. There has to be a better way to live. This book is for anyone courageous enough to admit to their hypocrisy. I hope it pushes you, challenges you, and disturbs you. And if you're honest before God, as I am trying to be in this book, perhaps together we can shed some of our hypocrisy and live a life that truly brings glory to Christ. What authentic, real honesty there from Greg Groeschel, a pastor and an author. And please allow me to echo his thoughts and say that I too sometimes see this very thought process in my own life at times. In fact, I saw a quote by another Christian pastor while I was surfing Facebook the other day, and the post simply said these words, and I don't know who this brother in Christ was, and I don't know where he lives or who he is. I just found it fascinating. It was shared by a friend on Facebook, and I found it to be very, very compelling and wanted to share it today. And those words that this pastor said was, you will never change what you tolerate. So if any of us want to change the way we live and the way we think, we are going to have to come to a place where we no longer accept things for what they are. Now, most of you are probably familiar with what is commonly known as the Prayer of Serenity by Reinhold Niebuhr. God, grant me the serenity to accept the things I cannot change, courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference. I've shared that with many of the men and women I worked with in, as an addiction counselor in recovery ministry for 10 years. And the problem is that sometimes we don't know the difference when we pray this prayer. We assume that we cannot change because this is who we are. We've allowed our failures to define us, and we based our entire identity on who we are at our worst. We've accepted what we're sure we cannot change. But the serenity did not come with it. Why? Because God has a different plan for you. You do have an enemy who wants you to accept defeat. But God says in Jeremiah 29 and 11, for I know the plans that I think toward you, says the Lord. Plans to prosper you and not to harm you. Plans to give you a hope and a future soul. Today, I believe the Lord wants to give you hope for a turnaround. He wants your future to be different and more blessed than you could ever have imagined. And He wants to do this through the Holy Spirit, whom He has given to all who have called on His name. You reset your mindset when you are allowing the Holy Spirit to transform you by the renewing of your mind. God wants to change the way we think and the way we live. And so we're going to share, as we unpack this message today, on how we can reset our mindset. How we can have a purer, a holier, a more righteous, a more peaceful mindset. We see people troubled in their minds each and every day. They're troubled about many things. I'm reminded of the words that Jesus said to Martha when He sat and had dinner at the home of Mary and Martha and Lazarus. And Martha was busy serving and waiting upon the Lord and preparing a meal and entertaining all of the guests, while Mary was seated at the feet of Jesus. And Martha asked Jesus, "Do you not care that my sister has left me to serve alone?" And Jesus said, "Martha, Martha, you are troubled about many things." What He was saying was, you're not thinking and seeing this with the right mindset. And so this morning, I want us to realize that it is possible for us to reset our mindset. So let's look at our first point that we want to convey this morning and share as we unpack the message. And that is this: we have to focus on evaluating our mindset. So point number one that we share today is on evaluating our mindset. Go back to Romans chapter 8. Let's look at verses 5 through 8 as we tick off these points this morning. And Paul writes, "For they that are after the flesh do mind the things of the flesh, but they that are after the Spirit, the things of the Spirit. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. Because the carnal mind is enmity against God, for it is not subject to the law of God, neither indeed can be. So then they that are in the flesh cannot please God." Now the word mind here that the writer uses in Romans 8, 5 through 8, when Paul is sharing this thought, refers to disposition or attitude. It's your way of thinking about life. Some would call it a paradigm or a worldview or a perspective. It involves more than your ability to think and form thoughts. It has to do with the way you see God, the way you see truth, the way you see others, the way you see yourself. It is a collection of all of your presuppositions or assumptions that guide the way you think and choose to live. I believe we can evaluate our mindset based on how we think about various situations in life. When faced with decisions about what we will believe or what we will do, here are some telling questions we can ask ourselves that come right out of the verse of Scripture I just read in Romans 8, 5 through 8. Ask ourselves, is this what God wants? Is this consistent with life and peace? Does this bring honor to God or reflect hostility to God? And who is in control here, the Holy Spirit or me? If we do this humbly and honestly, I believe the Holy Spirit will help us discern our mindset, give us courage to change the things we can with His help. That's why David said in Psalm 139, verse 23 and 24, "Search me, O God, and know my heart. Try me and know my thoughts. And see if there be any wicked way in me, and lead me in the way everlasting." In order to get an accurate view of our mindset, we need God to show us. 1 Corinthians 2 and 10 speaks of the Spirit searches all things. And when He shows us an area that needs to change, we need to willingly surrender to Him, which leads to not only a change in our mindset, but a change in attitude. That takes us to our second point of this main thought. And point two that we want to convey is we want to look at surrendering our mindset. Now, it's one thing to evaluate your mindset and see where you're at, but then comes the action of surrendering your mindset. In Romans chapter 8, verses 9 and 10, the scriptures tell us, but ye are not in the flesh, but in the spirit. If so be that the Spirit of God dwell in you. Now, if any man have not the Spirit of Christ, he is none of his. And if Christ be in you, the body is dead because of sin, but the Spirit is life because of righteousness. We surrender our mindset to Christ and to God when we come to know Jesus as our Savior. However, if all of our decisions are self-based, then where does the Holy Spirit fit in here? How can we say that we are led by the Spirit, controlled by the Spirit, directed by the Spirit, if we do not give the Holy Spirit control of our thoughts, those decisions that we make in our lives and every day of our life? Until we come to God on His terms and surrender ourselves entirely to Him, we cannot honor Him with our thoughts or with our behavior. If God's Spirit lives in us, then we must stop living like He doesn't live in us. We've got to maintain the mindset that if we are controlled by the Holy Spirit, then we need to give up control of our lives and stop relying on self. And how do you do this? By surrendering your heart and your mind to the Holy Spirit. Paul gives two conditions in these two verses I read that will produce a Spirit-controlled life instead of trying in our own human effort to do it. If the Spirit of God lives in you, or if you have the Spirit of Christ, and if Christ is in you, they basically mean the same thing. Namely, that you are willing to turn away from the wrong in your life and surrender yourself to Jesus, trusting Him to forgive you and change you forever. And in addition to the surrender, there are actions we can take that God has given us in His Spirit-filled, anointed Word that'll help us live a Spirit-controlled life. But it all comes back to surrendering to Him. You have to not just give your heart to Jesus Christ, but He has to control your heart, your body, your mind. So many people are not thinking right. They have not been transformed by the renewing of their mind. They've been saved and washed in the blood, but they don't realize that there has to be a transforming work that takes place when our mind and our thinking changes. And that leads us to our third point that we want to convey. And I want us to talk about redirecting our mindset. We looked at evaluating our mindset. We look secondly at surrendering our mindset. Now, thirdly, we're going to talk about redirecting our mindset. Colossians chapter 3, verses 1, 2, and 3, Paul says, since then you have been raised with Christ, set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. In Romans 12 and 2, Paul says, and be not conformed to this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind, that you may prove what is that good and acceptable and perfect will of God. The Bible tells us in 2 Corinthians chapter 10 and verse 5 that we're bringing into captivity every thought to the obedience of Christ. So that tells us that we have to think on things above, not on things on the earth. We have to be renewed in our minds so that we can be transformed by the renewing of our minds, and that we are to take those thoughts captive and make them obedient to Christ, which means we don't think the same way we used to think. Philippians chapter 4, verse number 8 says, fix your thoughts on what is true, and honorable and right. Think about things that are pure and lovely and admirable. Think about things that are excellent and worthy of praise. We need to redirect our mindset and start thinking in a way that is not only aligned with the Word of God, but also is the mind of Christ. When Philippians 2 and 5 says, "Let this mind be in you, which was also in Christ Jesus," that talks about not just a surrendered mind. Okay? It also talks about redirecting our thought processes. Jesus tried to convey to us in his earthly ministry the importance of faith, the importance of trusting. How many times do we read in the Word of God where Jesus said, "Be not afraid, only believe. Be not afraid, it is I. Let not your hearts be troubled. You believe in God, believe also in me." He's saying there, you redirect your thinking and start to think in a heavenly form and in a heavenly mindset. And do not think about things on this earth, and let that dwell in you. Because if we truly, truly think about things that are honorable, that are true, that are righteous, that are lovely, that are admirable, that are pure, that are excellent, worthy of praise, those are the things we should think on. And that leads us to our final point today, and that is point number 4. And I want to talk about encouraging our mindset. Romans chapter 8, verse 11 says, "But if the Spirit of him that raised up Jesus from the dead dwell in you, he that raised up Christ from the dead shall also quicken your mortal bodies by his Spirit that dwelleth in you." Now, if the Holy Spirit can resurrect your body, which it's going to do someday at the rapture of the church and the resurrection of the just, he can surely transform your mind. He already displayed his power when he gave breath back into Jesus in the tomb. And do you know that the word spirit and breath both come from the same word, pneuma, which is where we get pneumatica in the Bible. The same Spirit of God, the same Holy Spirit, the breath of God, who breathed life into the body of Jesus and also breathed the breath of life into to Adam, the same breath that Jesus breathed on his disciples in the Gospel of John and said, "Receive ye the Holy Ghost." That same Spirit also lives in you and me, and it can reset our mind to think holy and righteous thoughts and allow us to live a holy life. David was a man after God's own heart. He was anointed to be the king of Israel. And while he and his mighty men of valor were fugitives and on the run being pursued by King Saul, they were ransacked and attacked at Ziklag at their encampment. And the Bible says that the enemy took off with their wives and their children. And they wept and they wailed at the loss. And some of them even wanted to put David to death. And the Bible says that David encouraged himself in the Lord. What was it that allowed David to encourage himself in the Lord? It was his mindset. He refused to live with a negative mindset. He didn't do that. He encouraged his mindset. And he realized that I am still the anointed of God. God still has a plan. God still has a purpose. And this will turn around. God has a positive for this negative. We need to reset our mindset to realize that God is in control. God has a plan. God has a purpose. And we can trust in him. So as we conclude this morning, I want to just once again remind you of these points that I shared with you this morning. We talk about the topic of reset your mindset. You need to evaluate your mindset. Search me, O God. Let that be your prayer. Search me, O God. Know my thoughts. Know my heart. Surrender your mindset. Let the Holy Spirit begin to control your your not only your life, but your thoughts. Redirect your mindset. Think on things that are above. Let your thoughts be God's thoughts. Let the Holy Spirit transform your mindset so that you can redirect your thoughts into the proper mindset. Get out of the land of the negative. And lastly, encourage your mindset. The Spirit can change you. The same power that breathed life into Jesus, the same Spirit that regenerated him and brought salvation when you were born again and accepted Jesus Christ as your Lord and Savior, is the same Spirit that can change your thoughts. We simply cannot have the same mindset, attitude, thought process, and thought patterns. We need to reset our mindset. These are troubling times we're living in. And I choose to live in faith. I refuse to walk and live in fear. I choose to think God's thoughts. I will not think the thoughts of man. For to be carnally minded is death, but to be spiritually minded is life and peace. So as we close with the word of prayer, I encourage you this week, pray and ask God to give you the right mindset. Lord, reset my mindset. Let me start to think the right thoughts. Let me have the mind of Christ. Let me walk by faith and not by sight. And I promise you, God will bring victory and blessing into your life. Join with me as we close this morning with a word of prayer. Heavenly Father, we thank you for this message we've heard from your word today. We pray that you will help us, Lord, to hear this word and receive it into our hearts. We know faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. And Lord, we've shared the word of God and the scriptures in this message today as we've conveyed the thought and the point of reset our mindset. Lord, let our thoughts be your thoughts. Let this mind be in each of us that was in Christ Jesus. Lord, take us out of the land of the negative. Don't let us think fearfully, anger, bitterness, disappointment, discouragement. All those thoughts, Lord, we rebuke and bind them. And Lord, just flood our hearts and our minds with good thoughts, with right thoughts. Lord, as we go into this next week of our lives, we pray you'll bless us, Lord. Lord, give us a positive attitude, a new attitude, but Lord, the right attitude. And Lord, bring us back as we leave this place today. Bring us back at the appointed time when we gather again together. Bless us with a good week, Lord. Prosper us and keep us in health, even as our soul prospers. And we ask all these things in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, thank you again for joining with me. I pray that you'll have a wonderful week this upcoming week. I pray that God will bless you and be with you. And from all of us here at Lebanon Rock Church, thank you for being with us. Have a blessed week, and we look forward to having you with us again when we gather next time.